In this video, we're continuing on with the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 2 free worksheet graphing absolute value equations. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Picking up where we left off with number 7, setting up our T table. We're going to start by solving for our vertex. Our vertex occurs when what's inside the absolute value is equal to 0. So 2x plus 2 equals 0. Subtracting 2, 2x equals negative 2, and dividing both sides by 2, we get that x equals negative 1. So when x is negative 1, we're going to be at our vertex, plugging negative 1 in for x. So when x is equal to negative 1, we'll have negative 2 times the absolute value of 2 times negative 1 plus 2, and then adding 4 after that absolute value quantity. That is equal to negative 2. What's inside the absolute value we know is 0, so that's negative 2 times 0 plus 4, which is going to equal negative 2 times 0 is 0 plus 4 is 4. So we're going to start by plotting negative 1, 4. Now I'll choose a value to the left, and I'll choose a value to the right. I'll choose negative 3, and I'll choose 0. So when x is negative 3, I'll have negative 2 times the absolute value of 2 times negative 3 plus 2 plus 4. So I'll have negative 2 times the absolute value, 2 times negative 3 is negative 6, plus 2, and then we're adding 4. That'll be negative 2 times the absolute value of negative 6 plus 2, which is the absolute value of negative 4, and then we're adding 4. So it'll be negative 2 times positive 4 plus 4, which equals negative 8 plus 4, which is a negative 4. So when x is negative 3, y is negative 4. And when x is 0, we'll have negative 2 times the absolute value of 2 times 0 plus 2 plus 4. That would be negative 2 times the absolute value of 2 times 0, which is 0 plus 2, so the absolute value of 2 plus 4. Negative 2 times the absolute value of 2 is going to be negative 4, and we're adding 4 to that. Negative 4 plus 4 equals 0. So then we're going to plot 0, 0. Let's go ahead and draw two lines that connect at the vertex. And that is our answer for problem number 7. Let's move on to number 8. In number 8, our vertex occurs when 3x minus 3 is equal to 0. So 3x minus 3 equals 0. We're going to add 3 to both sides to get that 3x is equal to 3. And when we divide by 3, we get x equals positive 1. So when x is 1, we're at our vertex. So for our t-table, let's solve our x and y values. When x is 1, we're going to be at our vertex. So that's going to be negative 3 times the absolute value of 3 times 1 minus 3, which we know is 0, plus 1. Negative 3 times 0 is 0, plus 1 will give us a positive 1. So our vertex occurs at point 1, 1. So let's pick a point to the left. Let's say 0. So when x is 0, we'll have negative 3 times the absolute value of 3 times 0 minus 3 plus 1. So it'll be negative 3 times the absolute value, 3 times 0 is 0, 0 minus 3 is negative 3. So negative 3 times the absolute value of negative 3 plus 1. That'll be negative 3 times a positive 3, which will be negative 9, and we're adding 1 to that to give us negative 8. So let's plot 0, negative 8. You can see that when we plot this, we go off the graph in the y direction. Keeping our spacing the same, that would be negative 7, so here is negative 8. Now when we pick a point to the right of 1, let's pick something a little smaller away. Let's do 1 and 1 third, which we can write as 4 thirds. So we'll have negative 3 times the absolute value of 3 times 4 thirds minus 3 plus 1. That'll be negative 3 times the absolute value of 3 times 4 thirds is 4, minus 3 plus 1. So that would be negative 3 times the absolute value of positive 1 plus 1. That'll give us negative 3 plus 1 is negative 2. So let's graph 4 thirds, negative 2. 4 thirds, 1 and 1 third, and then negative 2. Now let's connect those lines. And that's our answer in number 8. Let's move on to number 9. In number 9, our vertex occurs when what's inside the absolute value is 0. So 2x minus 3 equals 0. I'm going to add 3 to both sides of that to get that 2x equals 3. And when I divide by 2, I'll get x equals 3 halves. So our vertex occurs when x has a value of 3 halves. So for our t-table, we'll have x and y is equal to 2 times the absolute value of 2x minus 3. When x is 3 halves, we know that what's inside the absolute value will be 0. So we'll get 2 times the absolute value of 0, which is equal to 0. Start by graphing 3 halves, 0. 3 halves is 1 and 1 half, and then 0 in the y direction. Now we'll pick a point to the left and a point to the right. I'll choose positive 1 in the x. So I'll have 2 times the absolute value of 2 times 1 minus 3. That'll be 2 times the absolute value of 2 minus 3, which is negative 1. 2 times the absolute value of negative 1 is 2 times 1, which is 2. So next, I'll plot 1, 2. And I know that my absolute value equation is reflected over the vertical line that intersects my vertex. So I'm going to go ahead, knowing that 2 is my y value when I'm half a step to the left, I know that 2 will also be my y value when I'm a half a step to the right. So when I'm at 1 in the x, I'll be at 2 in the y, going half a step to the right. When I'm at 2 in the x, I'll also be at 2 in the y. And then I'll connect those lines. And that's my answer in number 9. However, let's double check to ensure we got the right point. So I'm going to plug 2 in for x. Plugging 2 in for x, I'll get 2 times the absolute value of 2 times 2 minus 3. That'll be 2 times the absolute value of 4 minus 3, which is 2 times the absolute value of 1, which indeed equals 2. So remembering that the absolute value is reflected over the vertical line that intersects the vertex will help make graphing easier. So let's continue on with number 10, remembering our helpful tips. First, let's solve for the vertex. So I'll have negative 3x minus 3 equal to 0. Add 3 to both sides to get that negative 3x equals positive 3. When I divide by negative 3, I'll get that x equals negative 1. So our vertex occurs when x is equal to negative 1. So when x is negative 1, I'll get 3 times the absolute value of 0, which equals 0. So my vertex occurs at negative 1, 0. Next, I'll pick one point either to the left or to the right, and I know that that is going to be reflected. And since my x value is getting multiplied to a 3, I'm going to pick a fraction with 3 on the bottom. So I'm going to choose negative 1 third. So approximately here on the number line. Choosing negative 1 third, I'll plug that into my equation. So I have 3 times the absolute value of negative 3 times negative 1 third minus 3. That'll be 3 times the absolute value of negative 3 times negative 1 third is a positive 1 minus 3. So that'll be 3 times the absolute value of negative 2, which is 3 times positive 2, which is 6. So next, I'm going to plot negative 1 third, 6, which falls here. Now negative 1 third is 2 thirds to the right of negative 1. So if I go 2 thirds to the left of negative 1, I'll also have the same value, and that's a value of 6. So negative 2 thirds to the left of negative 1 will be negative 5 thirds 6. Then I'll draw a line to connect. And that's my answer in number 10. In number 11, I'll first solve for my vertex. So negative 3x plus 4 equals 0. Subtracting 4 from both sides, I'll get that negative 3x equals negative 4. Divided by negative 3, I'll get that x equals 4 thirds. So my vertex occurs when x equals 4 thirds. Setting up my t-table, when x is 4 thirds, I'll have 2 times the absolute value of 0 minus 3. 2 times 0 is 0, minus 3, which is negative 3. So when x is 4 thirds, y will be negative 3. So positive 4 thirds is 1 and 1 third, and then I'm going down 3. Now I'm going to solve for when x is 0. When x is 0, I'll have 2 times the absolute value of negative 3 times 0 plus 4 minus 3. That'll be 2 times the absolute value of 4, since negative 3 times 0 is 0, and we're still adding 4, and then we're subtracting 3 from that. 2 times the absolute value of 4 is 8, minus 3 will give me 5. So when x is 0, y is 5. Now I know that 0 is 4 thirds away from our vertex of 4 thirds. So 0 is 4 thirds to the left of our vertex, 1 third, 2 third, 3 thirds, 4 thirds. So now I'm going to move 4 thirds to the right. 1 third, 2 third, 3 thirds, 4 thirds. And I'm going to plot that point, that x value, with a y value of 5. So 4 thirds to the right of 4 thirds will be 8 thirds. So at 8 thirds, I'll also have a value of 5. Now I'll draw a line and connect. And if you wanted to double check 8 thirds, you could plug in 8 thirds for x and see that that'll be the absolute value of negative 8 plus 4, which is the absolute value of negative 4. And remember, the absolute value of negative 4 is the same as the absolute value of 4. So indeed, we have 0, 5, and 8 thirds 5. Let's move on to our last problem, number 12. And before I go over the answer to this, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. For number 12, let's calculate the x value of the vertex. That occurs when negative 2x plus 4 equals 0. Subtracting 4 from both sides, I'll get negative 2x equal to negative 4. And when I divide both sides by negative 2, I'll get that x is equal to negative 4 divided by negative 2, which is a positive 2. So our vertex occurs when x equals 2. Setting up our t-table, x, y, which is negative 3 times the absolute value of negative 2x plus 4 plus 3. When x is 2, what's inside the absolute value is equal to 0. So I have negative 3 times the absolute value of 0 plus 3. Negative 3 times 0 is 0 plus 3 is a positive 3. So my first point, my vertex, is at 2, 3. Next, I'll go ahead and choose 3. And remember, 3 is 1 to the right of 2. So the y value of 3 will get reflected as the y value for 1, since 1 is 1 to the left of 2 and 3 is 1 to the right. So plugging 3 in for x, I'll get negative 3 times the absolute value of negative 2 times 3 plus 4, and adding 3 to that. That'll be negative 3 times the absolute value of negative 6 plus 4 plus 3. Negative 3 times the absolute value of negative 6 plus 4 is the absolute value of negative 2, and we're adding 3 to that. Negative 3 times the absolute value of negative 2 is going to result in negative 6 plus 3 equals negative 3. So when we're at 3 for x, we're at negative 3 for y. And remember, that point is reflected when x is equal to 1. So now I'm going to graph those lines. And that is my final answer in number 12. If Feel free to double check the point 1, negative 3 on your own. And in order to double check, and remember when double checking, you're going to be taking that value of 1 and plugging it in for x in the equation and seeing that if negative 3 does indeed equal y. Once you plug in 1 for x, comment below and let me know if you got negative 3 for y. Also comment if you have any questions or you need a clarification on any of the problems that we went over in this video. And as always, please remember to like and subscribe.